This was the moment that police abandoned 44 hours of softly negotiations. Armed officers have fired gas grenades into the van. Still, there are loudspeaker appeals for Begri to give himself up. Then the dull thud of a shotgun blast, which meant that the siege of Philbeach Gardens was over. Come daylight and the van was gone, towed away for analysis by forensic scientists. A vase of tulips sums up the feelings of at least one local resident who thought Begri's death was unnecessary. But minutes after the end, the man in charge of police operations said he had to act.
Policy from the start was that we would end this matter peacefully, with Begri returned to prison, certainly with no injury at all. And we moved towards that end. He was given every opportunity as the day wore on to give himself up. He indicated quite firmly that he would not do so. The approach that was made to the vehicle was made with a view to him, to allowing him to give himself up even at that late stage, but he chose to take another course.
Scotland Yard wouldn't be interviewed this afternoon, but said in a statement that Begri may have been irrational. He'd survived only on water from the van radiator and amphetamine drugs. The risk he'd come out shooting or commit suicide was real. Police had to take the initiative. But that doesn't satisfy the critics.
There may have been good reasons for the police going in when they did, but I still haven't had an answer to the question as to why they chose to go in just 2 days after the siege started. There's no indication that people in the area were in any immediate danger, and it doesn't seem to be an answer as to why there wasn't a case for holding on a bit longer and trying to talk him out.
Begri's boss, who knew him as Brian Robinson, hoped he might have acted as mediator.
The call was made by the PC just for us to call there, and we assumed they were going to let us speak to Brian. When we got there, we asked this, could we speak to Brian? And they said that they'd check with the negotiator, and that he said that if they needed us, they'd ring us. And I waited here till just after two, and nobody rang. I went to bed, and at that time he was already dead.
I offered my help, and they just went ahead.
What should they have done?
Tried all possibilities to get him out of there. I felt maybe a voice from home might have got him out.
And residents of Philbeach Gardens admit a sympathy with the plight of the convicted murderer.
Obviously, he was a very desperate man. Like, there was no way he was going to go back to prison. But, like, the guy that we knew certainly wouldn't attach him to being a killer or anything like that.
We know that he was... The whole reason for holding out the siege is he didn't want to go back to prison. So, I mean, perhaps one's reaction could be that it's best in the long run that it did end the way it did.